Good morning, good evening, and good afternoon. Welcome back. And today I have for you my Crystalline Conflict guide to the Black Mage. A role which is both simple to learn and is also highly oppressive. Powerful area of effect damage, the most crowd control of any role, allows you to be the carry of every match. I shall be covering all abilities and a very nice combo, strategies, strengths, and weaknesses. And thank you all for the continued support. As this video goes live, we are about to reach 2400 subscribers. Enjoy the video, let me know down below if this helps, and I shall see you all in the next one. Let us begin with the basics, which often confuse many players. Fire and Blizzard. These are the first in a three-part rotation. Fire goes into Fire 4, ending with Flare. Blizzard becomes Blizzard 4, ending with Freeze. How these rotations work and their damage is identical. Where they differ is within their additional ability. To put simply, Fire equals damage over time, while the Ice equals crowd control. To access these additional abilities, you must cast Super Flare. This will trigger an effect that strikes all within a 30-yard radius of your selected target. While using Fire spells, you will obtain stacks of Astral Warmth, and under the Ice rotation, stacks of Umbral Ice. Both can hold a maximum of 3 stacks, and will be reset if you use the opposite spell type. These stacks is what determines Super Flare's effect. For every stack of either Fire or Ice, Super Flare deals 3,000 damage, up to 9,000 for all 3 stacks. When used with stacks of Astral Warmth, your target is inflicted with damage over time, starting at 6 seconds, up to a maximum of 12 depending on your stack count. Whereas the Ice rotation works very differently. Super Flare under 1 stack applies Heavy, under 2 stacks inflicts Bind, under the max of 3 stacks applies Deep Freeze. To get access to a full 3 stacks fast, you begin with Fire or Blizzard, then use your instant ability, Paradox, dealing a flat 8,000 damage, and boosting whichever stack you have to their full 3 count. But which rotation do you use? Well, majority of your combat will be focused around your Ice spells. The opening battle, grouped fights, and giving chase or defending yourself will benefit the most from crowd controlled effects of the Ice rotation. The Fire rotation is great in long drawn out battles. As everyone's resources are low, that burn damage can really affect the outcome. Under 1v1 situations, that very same burn can become the deciding factor. However, most fights, the crowd controlling from the Ice rotation secures more kills than going for the burn. You also have an ability called Burst. This deals a huge 16,000 damage, and also applies a 16,000 barrier. That barrier is applied regardless of whether or not you hit a target, meaning if you know you're about to get dived, you have the option to use it preemptively. To ensure Burst is an instant cast, you first use your Ethereal Manipulation. This ability allows you to move to a friendly, enemies, and most importantly, yourself, granting you one insta-cast with a 10-second timer to use. Using my macro on screen allows you to teleport to yourself with one button press to proc this effect. And I love to use this macro for the opening battle. For my Deep Freeze rotation, a really powerful opener for any fight is to start by using Ethereal Manipulation upon yourself. For two reasons, I can now use Blizzard without standing still, and I can use Burst instantaneously should I get dove. If I am free to do so, follow up with Paradox and Super Flare to Deep Freeze your main target. If the opportunity is there for a kill, follow up with a second Ethereal Manipulation into your Burst. At any stage, you can also throw Half Asleep into the mix. This will either force out Purifies, or catch someone off guard who has burned through theirs early. And last up, we have your Limit Break, Soul Resonance. This charges insanely fast, meaning you'll be using this almost on cooldown, and thanks to its 30 seconds of uptime, you can pop this earlier than you think, since you'll begin charging a brand new Limit Break upon activating your first one. With your Limit Break active, you will take 10% less damage. You'll be granted one cast of Foul for a strong instant 16,000 damage, and 6 stacks of Soul Resonance, allowing you to fire both Freeze and Flare with no cast time, meaning you are now at your most lethal, going in spamming in crowd control, and high area of effect damage to your heart's content. For round 1, there is a pretty nice team comp on both sides. My main focus is their Warrior and Dragoon. The Black Mage's ability at shutting down melee rolls is almost unrivaled, and if I can bait them in close, leaving their team behind, I can then take full advantage of those distractions. While my team goes for their backline, I like to start every match the same way. I Ethereal to myself, giving me 10 seconds of instant cast. In the opening battle, you almost always want to open with Deep Freeze. As you can see at the very start, this almost caused a fast death for their red mage. Their dragoon sees an opening to dive me. My white mage shuts this down with a well-timed imp. However, he does not back down. And I can see their warrior is joining the fray. In this situation, burst is your best bet. Not for the damage, rather for the huge shield. Doing so puts me in the position where I do not need to flee in panic, instead being able to hold out, and keeping their warrior distracted with a deep freeze. Meanwhile, my team is freely running amok in their backline, and because I used burst early, not only do I have a good amount of resource to work with, I also had another burst off cooldown to use offensively, leaving the warrior with no chance of escape. With the warrior out of the way, I am now in the best possible position. A black mage with no one to contest me, and this is where the stagger begins to form. With my limit break online, I can now hold off safe to the side, using the speed lane. I can flee should I need, however their dragoon no longer attempts to pressure me, a fatal mistake for any team, as now I can be as oppressive as I like. And oppressive play is just what you are aiming for. This is one of those jumps where you want to be near the objective, rather than pushing with your team. You want to be off to the side, safe and untouchable. Take those off angles, move in to finish kills fast, then pull back to prepare for enemy advances. Giving yourself that space allows you the free rein to shut down team battles before they begin. Again, you will see a lot of deep freeze. You have the most crowd control of any class, abuse it. As you can see, it clearly starts to annoy the enemy team. They become undecisive. There is the odd poke at me mixed with a back and forth to the objective. If they had committed to finishing me there and then, there was a good chance they could have made a recontest. I hang around just long enough to distract. Once I fall back, not only was their warrior off in his own 1v1, their red mage makes the rather odd play to approach me, leaving only their machines to hold the objective in a 1v3, resulting in a rather easy win. Round 2 is very much the same. However, this time, not only am I facing double melee, I am also facing another black mage. It is important I do whatever I can to keep their black mage from creating the same space I can. And right at the start, I begin by applying instacast to myself. Their dragoon makes the first move, making him the main target for my first ice stack. He instantly uses guard. I now know he plays aggressively and used himself as bait. I know his next move is to dive me. You can shut this down, using paradox and super flare, for a full 3 ice stacks into deep freeze. I can then follow up with burst for damage and shielding. I continue dropping back, slowly poking at those continuing to push. Now this is where many can get confused. Yes, they are moving the objective. However, this does not matter. The opening battle is all about the teamfight. Yes, they will get objective time. In doing so, giving space, we are slowly able to chip away. And as the black mage, I can stand off to the side, using my crowd controls to be oppressive. Not only are we killing them one by one for staggered spawns, which is made worse by their black mage's attempt to stall, rather than giving objective space like we did, we also obtained more objective time because we won that opening battle. With the first fight won, we now need to keep the momentum going. I use my limit break early while I am safe. Not only does this start charging my next limit break sooner, I also have 30 seconds to work with. That is more than enough time, making the scholar my first victim. Shutting him down before he can spread shields is huge. Their monk follows up with some poke and knocking me back. An interesting play, as a black mage I can just teleport back in. Now see how this has flipped from the first fight. Instead of taking fights to weaken and pick us off, they are instead diving the objective one by one to stall. This is just wasted effort, granting us easy kills, and seeing how little MP their dragoon has left, I am more than able to give chase. You can see their team has no desire to group or aid one another. They have all tunnel visioned on that objective, and with my summoner noticing the same opportunity, we made quick work of their dragoon. Straight after, I can now finally engage with their black mage, who attempted to flank my team on the objective. This is now on me to pressure him out. And because I used my first limit break early, my second one is now ready. Again using their objective tunnel vision, I can safely give chase once again. And with my samurai backing me up, there is no way he can survive, leaving me with a nice and easy cleanup on their monk once I return to the objective. This now leaves the enemy team very little time to make a comeback play. I shall let this portion unfold. Watch as I continue to abuse my crowd control, use distance to my advantage, playing the off angles, and shutting down those attempting to flank, and overall being a general nuisance. For your strengths, to start, you are unrivaled in crowd control. The only contest would come from an enemy Black Mage. You have access to Heavy, Bind, Deep Freeze, and Sleep, all of which can help you dominate and force out a player's Purify. Your movement ability is Ethereal Manipulation. This can be used upon yourself, allowing you to use Burst and Deep Freeze quickly in a fight. Whether that is for offense or defense, your Burst can also be used purely as a defensive. Simply using Burst will grant you a powerful barrier. You excel in fights where the enemies are grouped up and are unable to counter you. Your limit break is one of the fastest charging in the game, and the limit break itself lasts for 30 seconds, meaning popping this early is beneficial. Having limit break up while charging a second one can be insanely strong in long drawn out fights. Your kit works so well that not only can you sit back being oppressive, you can also within an instant dive in to clean up. As a Black Mage, you need to be ready to get dove. This role can anger many players, and those of experience will dive you on repeat. The Black Mage struggles to survive through burst damage, as your movement is rather limited, and your own defense requires the activation of burst beforehand. As a Black Mage, you must remain calm under pressure, which can be a struggle for a newer player. As devastating as you are to every single role out there, you must respect the enemy team. Getting cocky, no matter the class you are facing, can end rather badly. Overconfidence in your big damage numbers will get you killed rather quickly. And there you have it. Everything you need to begin picking up the Black Mage. And with time and practice, you will become a Black Mage who stands out above the rest. Thank you all for tuning in. Leave a comment down below for a recommendation to the next guide. And I will see you all in the next one.